Namaste children, how are you? I hope you all are healthy and fit, right? So before start the class, we will do one activity, okay? That is drinking water. First, take a glass of water with you, okay children? So I hope you took your glass of water, right? Shall we drink some water? Very good. Water, children? Yes, excellent. Increasing energy, improving concentration, reducing stress and weight loss. Right, children? Yes. So today we are going to learn about iron. Lesson 10, basic programming and concept is iron. Children, what do you mean by an array? An array is a collection of one or more values of the same type. Each value is called an element of the array. Or else, an array is a collection of similar kind of values stored in a variable. Let us see one example for an array. Children, look at this image. What did you observe in this image? Yes, in this image, we have six items of these are in same type. We can refer to each items as ball of 1, ball of 2 and ball of 3 and so on. An array can be categorized into two ways. One is numeric array and another one is string array. Let us see the syntax for an array. Students, look at these syntax. First syntax for creating numeric array and second syntax for creating string array. Let us see the first syntax. DIM, that is stands for dimension, and it is followed by array name, that is variable name, and then open parenthesis, index and close parenthesis. In the second statement, as same as for first statement, but while declaring string value, we have to include dollar sign at the end of the array name. Okay, children? Yes. Let us see one example of an array using the given syntax. So, start with the DIM statement and then write the array name. That is, variable name is marks. And then index value, that is 3. As same as the previous example, but here I have included dollar sign because of creating a string value. So here I am creating a variable name, that is names, with dollar sign. So at the end of the variable name with dollar sign. Students, let us see the example programs. This is the example for numeric array program. So in this program, we start with DIM statement and it is followed by variable name, that is array name. Array name is marks and its index value is 3. Next line, we are assigning 3 values to the variable name, that is marks. Next line, we are assigning a value together by using the element index in square brackets and along with the array name. Then print statement, which means print statement is used to print these statements or values. Students, when we execute this program, we will get the output. Students, what is the output? Yes, the total marks equal to 241. Students, look at the print statements. So, we are given the total marks within the double quotation. So it will be printed as same as in the output screen. Next, plus symbol. That is your concatenation operator, which means it joins two or more strings together. Next, total. That is call statement. So it will be retrieve the values in the variable total. So it will give answer as 241. Let us see one more example, students, for the numeric array, okay? Here the same elements can be assigned a value individually by using the element index in square brackets along with the array names and then print statement. So it will be printed the value in the output screen. So the output is 112. Students, next we will see the example program for string array. Okay, in this program first start with the give statement and variable name. Variable name is adjectives and it is followed by dollar sign which is denoted as string values, and then index value is 5. Very good. Next, we are given the values to the variable. So what are the values, students? Amazing, slippery, large, monthly, juicy. Next, print the variable name and then print. In this print statement, we are given the for statement. That is, it starts from the string value 0 to 4 and then print string variable name with the index of I and then next I, which means it will print the statement, which means string values one after another. So the output as adjectives: amazing, slippery, large, monthly, juicy. Okay students, I hope you have understood today's topic.